lapel of the Rodtang. There's the lapel. Wilson's on rubber legs. He goes down.
ปัจจัยในชีวิตก็รู้จักระเบียบมีระเบียบวินัยการฝึกฝนอะไรพวกนี้ครับต้องรู้จักกฎเกมของในค่ายครับ ก็ด้วยสไตล์การชกของเราครับไม่เอาเปรียบคนดูไม่เอาเปรียบคนจัดครับกระบู้ดุดันตลอดเวลาชกสนุกครับ อันดับหนึ่งก็ครอบครัวครับนั่นครอบครัวเรายากจนอะไรประมาณนี้ครับเราก็ต้องทำไงถึงจะได้เงินมาเลี้ยงครอบครัวละแล้วก็หันไปข้างๆมีเวทีมวยมีค่ายมวยก็เลยน่าจะเป็นทางที่ดีที่สุดในตอนนั้นครับ ก็เลยเลือกเดินสายนี้เลยก็รู้สึกดีใจด้วยครับแล้วก็ประสบความสำเร็จคือเป็นแชมป์ครับก็ดีใจครับที่มาถึงจุดนี้ ก็นานแล้วตั้งแต่แรกๆครับก็เข้ามาก็ทำฟอร์มมา4-5 ไฟครับกว่าจะได้ชิงเปลี่ยนครับต้องซ้อมหนักขึ้นแล้วก็รู้จักระเบียบขึ้นเพราะเราไปโกอินเตอร์นะครับเราต้องทำไอ้ดีเหมือนตัวแทนทุกไทยครับเปลี่ยนในทางที่ดีมากครับก็แบบอย่างเช่นผมดังอยู่ในไทยเนี้ยพอไปชกวันที่เป็นชิปก็เมืองนอกก็ดังเหมือนกันทุกอย่างครับเปลี่ยนหมด
Rodtang, the hottest Muay Thai athlete in the world right now.
หลังจากเป็นแชมป์ก็ดังมากขึ้นครับก็แบบนายจะไปไหนก็เขามีแต่คนทักว่านักมวยนายดังใหญ่แล้วนะอะไรเงี้ยประมาณนี้ครับแบบเขาก็ภูมิใจครับมีมาเรื่อยๆครับฝรั่งอะไรเงี้ยมาเรียนตลอดครับก็จะสไตล์รอหมัดต่อยหมัดเตะขาแบบ
Judge, ready, ready, go!
Come on, come on.
legs. Go! Not swing. Okay. Stand up, please. Okay. Go!
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Regarded as the best Muay Thai warrior on the planet right now, Pompeyak makes his one Super Series debut against Rui Botello. They are wearing 4-ounce gloves. The cage doors are locked. Referee Atsushi Onari gets us underway. Pompeyak in the glittering gold in southpaw start. He opens up the front kick and then a high-lift roundhouse kick. Watch for the excellence of execution in everything that Pompeyak does. Step through knee. Left cross from the tie. Botello's got to find a way to get on the inside. Get within range, get through the reach and go to the jaw, go to the liver, go to the ribs of Pompeyak. He's got to guard up against that left roundhouse kick.
He's got to keep that guard high, but he's also got to start circling. He's got to start circling to his left to avoid that big left roundhouse kick.
Pompeyak is patient. Cracks away to the inside lead by the Portuguese. Botello tests the waters downstairs. Needs the right hand for company. Double forearms guard against that left roundhouse kick. Botello far too flat-footed at the moment. He's got to move. He's got to start drifting to his left.
Standing right in front of Pompeyak. He's got to start moving, put those hands in, closing that distance. He's right in the perfect zone. That left kick.
That no man's land. In range for everything. Pompeyak wants authority. He throws a left hand down the center corridor. Pompeyak patience. Very light on the lead leg. Tracks away with that back leg again. That fabled, that feared left roundhouse kick with Pompeyak. Jitmuangnon. Front kick for the midsection. Digs into the belly button. There's one to the top of the leg. Roundhouse kick again from Pompeyak. Nice right hand lever from Botello. That's more like it from the Portuguese athlete. Roundhouse kick slapped into the lower ribs there, off the left from Pompeyak. First time in these 4 ounce gloves.
Now, the 4 ounce gloves change a lot of things. They change the defense. They change, you know, how you're going to counter, how you're going to move in. You know, you got to be very careful. But it also makes the clinch very effective, and it also adds a whole new element of power to the game.
Botello's dead. He studied a lot of tape from Pompeyak, and he said that in what he'd studied and having seen Pompeyak get knocked out before, that Pompeyak does a little lift often before he kicks. And if he can time Pompeyak on that lift, Botello may be able to connect, maybe with a roundhouse kick of his own. But being quite the shorter here, it will take a phenomenal effort to loop the roundhouse kick around the back of Pompeyak's neck.
Now that you mention it, you can start to see it. It's like a slight skip with his lead foot when he sets up that big roundhouse kick. It's a slight little step to initiate a little bit more power into the left kick. But then it comes very fast. Your reaction time needs to be incredibly quick. Here's Pompeyak coming straight through the middle with a beautiful left hand. And there's that left kick again. But Rui Botello was able to catch it on the arm there. He's taking a lot of shots. That's about 6 shots he's been able to catch on the arm. He's got to make sure he keeps that arm loose, nice and tight to his head. Ladies and gentlemen, you guys can vote for Bout of the Night on the One Super App. And you can win a trip to join us at a One event, which is probably the greatest event in the world of sports. Michael Schmello.
It is Destiny of Champions here tonight in Kuala Lumpur. It's not probably, it is Mitch Chilson.
There you go.
Final One Championship show of the year. Second round of this One Super Series match. Pompeyak on debut, taking on Rui Botello. Thailand versus Portugal. Let's see if Rui can pick up that little lift that Pompeyak does before he kicks. He believes it could be the chip in the armor. Something I've never seen before. Pompeyak's trainer has his monocle around his neck. Now, it's usually on a ring post. There are no ring posts here with the cage, however, but I hope in a very superstitious martial art that does not bring Pompeyak any bad luck. Probing the leg kicks here, Rui Botello, forearms guard against the high left roundhouse. Goes for the inside thigh, nice and high to that femoral profundo, but Pompeyak. Botello in the traditional Portuguese colours, the green and red.
Botello looks very effective when he's moving forward. When he starts throwing those hands, he closes the distance quick, but he's also getting caught with a little bit of a left hook by Pompeyak.
Patello landed a good combination a few moments ago. That should give him some more confidence. Goes for it again. Oh, cracking roundhouse kick from Pompey. Came agonizingly close. Patello fires out a front kick off the back leg. Pompey dropped down the center. Body kick from the tie. Roundhouse kick upstairs again. Patello sees them coming. It's one of those wicked roundhouse kicks like down or like Yodson fly. It could do so much damage. Fake there from Pompeya. Goes upstairs again, just breaking down that right arm of Rui Patello. There's only so many kicks Patello can take to that right forearm before the arm drops. And then we'll see if Pompeya can come over the top with a big kibosh.
I'd like to see Pompeya start going to the body of Patello more. Get him to start protecting that rib, that right side of his body with the elbow. And then he can start working his way up to the head. Patello's okay to take those on the arm.
Patello unloading on Pompeya for a moment and the crowd rallied behind the Portuguese star. Under a minute remaining, second round of three. Three judges are scoring on a 10-point must system. You give the winning boxer 10 points, the less dominant boxer 9 points. Finest roundhouse kick knockdowns you're ever going to see from that man, Pompeya. Third and final. Unofficially, first round Pompeya 10-9, second round Pompeya 10-8. That is our unofficial scorecard.
Final round! Go!
Atsushi Onari gets us underway, third round. The crowd wants to see a big knockout. Pompeya came close to it with that roundhouse kick in the second stanza. What a weapon! What ferocity!
Patello needs to glue that right hand to the side of his head. He says he was going to circle left, but he's still standing right in the pocket. Intent to trade with Pompeya. It's a recipe for disaster, though.
Patello has not adhered to the game plan he said he would. Big front kick there from Pompeya. Patello points it on the inside, catches the kick again, tries for a left hook.
That's his combination. He goes for that push kick with the lead leg, with the lead right leg, and then he comes over top with that right round or left roundhouse kick. He faked it, and that's what caught Patello. He was expecting the push kick to come in, but he faked it, lifting up his left right foot and coming over the top of the left kick.
Pompeya looks fresh, not a drop of sweat on him. Not a bruise, not a scratch. He has been dominant in his one Super Series debut. And that left roundhouse kick has been something extraordinary to behold. Inside leg kick from Patello. Roving with the jab, the Portuguese. Got to go to his left. He continues to wear these roundhouse kicks. That one was dropped to the ribcage. 1 minute 20 remains. Ampayak sends him 5 paces back with a front kick to the solar plexus.
Those push kicks that are setting up that left roundhouse kick, it comes from the front with the lead leg, and it's also coming from the back. It's both an offensive and defensive weapon. Botello some confidence. He needs to take advantage of that.
No knockdown, says the referee. Can Botello capitalize, though? That left hand's been his best weapon, the little man from Portugal.
You hear the cracking sound that left kick is landing on the right hand of Botello.
And the clinch here, no knees exchange. Referee, oh, no pressure. As Botello, he's got another one of those left hooks in the final. Combination there from the Portuguese. Botello's got a swing, and he's got a swing now. Final 10 seconds. It'll be a decision win for Pampayak unless Botello can find a Hail Mary left hook here.
So push kick from Pampayak. Look at the way he's throwing those push kicks, Michael Cervello. He's consistently attacking with the front push kick, with the back push kick. And that's what led to the damage that was inflicted in the second round. He was landing that push kick, and then he fakes the left push kick. Watch his right, watch his left leg. Boom, it comes up, gets Botello thinking about it, and boom, he comes right over the top, and Botello crumbles to the ground. Beautiful display of Muay Thai craftsmanship from Pampayak. But Botello started to come back and surge forward, in that third round. But overall, Pampayak, brilliant performance in his debut in one Super Series.
Pampayak looking unscathed. We believe the winner's medal will go back to Thailand. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner.
Back to time.